At that time, it was only La ilaha illallah. And this is the message of all the prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
So I can read the La ilaha illallah also.
But now, the kalima after the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you should say La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. But by the way, saying La ilaha illallah by itself is sufficient. Because now saying La ilaha illallah requires in believing in the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In the four kalimas which the Mufassirin refer to, and they said that this is the meaning of this ayah of Surah Al-Kahf. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-mal wal-banun zinatu al-hayati al-dunya wal-baqiyatu al-salihatu khayrun inda rabbika thawaban wa khayrun amal. الباقيات الصالحات, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wealth and children are the zina, the beauty of this dunya. والباقيات الصالحات, the remaining righteous deeds, خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير أملا, are better before your Lord as far as ثواب, compensation and reward, and as better, and better as far as hope in entering Al-Jannah and being pleased with Allah and having Allah being pleased with you. The four words or Al-Baqiyatu Salihat is to say Subhanallah, Walhamdulillah, Wa La Ilaha Illallah, Wallahu Akbar. So here you say it without saying Muhammadur Rasulullah. But it is inclusive because we already, every person today who says La Ilaha Illallah, he already believes in Muhammad Rasulullah as well, because saying La ilaha illallah without believing in Muhammad as the last messenger of Allah doesn't work, doesn't help. It will not be of any use, because La ilaha illallah, you believe in him, you believe in his word, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the last messenger. And how did we get to know about Allah? From Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But at the time of Musa alayhi salam, and the hadith, as I mentioned, was pertaining saying La ilaha illallah. Okay? There is a hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam says, the best dua and the best time to make dua is on the day of Arafah. And he said, وَخَيْرُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي. Observe this. And he said, the best statement that I and all the prophets who preceded me have said, La ilaha illallah. وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. So when Musa عليه السلام and his followers said لا إله إلا الله, that also pertained, I believe that Moses was the prophet of Allah, because if Bani Israel did not believe in Moses as the messenger of Allah, how would they get to know about Allah? If Isa عليه السلام didn't say La ilaha illallah, how would these guys who changed the religion after Moses and after all these prophets would know that he's a messenger from Allah, or would know the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Every time Allah sends and appoints a prophet in order to remove disbelief and shirk and establish faith, iman and monotheism. So that's why there it was La ilaha illallah at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, La ilaha illallah. But it requires every person who wants to establish the concept of faith to say La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. Jazakumullah khair.